तो भैया अब हम लोगों को फिर से झेलिए आप लोग. हाय गाइस, सो ऑन माय लेफ्ट वी हैव निखिल ओझा. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू एड्रेस हिम एज डॉक्टर बिकॉज इट्स नॉट अबाउट व्हाट ही इज टुडे. दिस होल थिंग इज अबाउट व्हाट ही वाज 35 इयर्स अगो. उस टाइम में निखिल थे, ओझा थे, ओझा साहब थे, ठीक है ना. खोगन सिंह, वेरी ओल्ड खोगन सिंह, यू नो तुम्हारे बारे में जो वट एवर आई यू नो whenever I visualize about you is that straight erect which he is, the way he is today, even that posture, you know, the smart handsome guy, no nonsense kind of a guy. So welcome guys.
Wo yaad aaya tha mere ko ke football khelte khelte main gir gaya aur mera left hand fracture ho gaya. Or
so this was like later part of the thing or younger days?
No, I think it was in ninth somewhere. Or बोला के हाथ में लग गई है तो जो मेरे को आई एम नॉट रिमेम्बरिंग के कौन से टीचर थे उस समय, बट वो बोले अरे खेलते चलो कुछ नहीं हुआ है तुम ऐसे ही एक्टिंग कर रहे हो. तो मैं वापस खेलने लगा और फिर वापस वैसे ही स्लिप हो गया. वो बारिश के दिन थे एंड सेकेंड टाइम स्लिप हुआ तो मेरा पूरा हाथ यहाँ से ऐसा मुड़ गया. तो वो हम तीनों से शायद कहीं रिलेटेड नहीं था, पर वो अभी रिसेंटली स्कूल गया जब मेरे को याद आया.
हम लोग
हाँ रेंज ग्राउंड नंबर 1 में. और फिर उसके बाद में एक 11th में मैं हम लोगों की टीम का था और वही फुटबॉल. हालांकि मैं कभी भी कोई स्पोर्ट्स में बहुत आगे नहीं रहा, या खाली क्योंकि खेलना पड़ता था इसलिए खेलते थे. सो मुझे याद है कि खेलते कैसे पीछे से मेरे को बॉल किसी ने दूसरे ने मारी थी और मेरे सिर पे बहुत ज़ोर से लगी और सामने एक खोगेन दिख गया मेरे को. डू यू रिमेंबर इट? तो मेरे को लगा कि इसने मारा है और मेरा इससे झगड़ा हुआ, पर वो आज तक मेरे को नहीं मालूम कि किसने मारी थी. सो बट आई स्टिल
खेलते खेलते लगी हुई है ऐसी किसी ने ऐसा
नहीं खेलते खेलते लगी थी. पर्पजली मारा नहीं मारा तो याद नहीं है, पर जैसा तूने बोला वो बिल्कुल सही है कि खोगन का एक ऐसी शख्सियत थी, एक ऐसी पर्सनालिटी थी कि वो आज तक भी नहीं. आज मैं शायद इससे मेरे को याद आ रहा था, मैंने बीच में बहुत बार बात भी करी पर 35 साल बाद मिले, पर आई स्टिल रिमेंबर हिज द वे ही यूज़ टू वॉक एंड द वे ही यूज़ टू स्माइल. आई फील नाउ दैट ही इज़ नॉट स्माइलिंग द टाइम टाइप ऑफ स्माइल विच ही यूज़ टू हैव एट द टाइम स्कूल के समय. और सब लोगों के साथ वो जो आखिरी के 2 साल जो तूने भी बोला बायो सेक्शन वाला, बायो सेक्शन में एक सबसे इंसिडेंटल चीज़ मुझे याद है कि मेरे को कुछ डिफरेंट करने का था तो मैंने इंग्लिश लिटरेचर ले लिया. और इंग्लिश लिटरेचर लिया तो उसमें बायो सेक्शन से ही संगीता और अनुराधा मिश्रा और एक बंदा और कोई था, हम 4 जने थे खाली इंग्लिश लिटरेचर लेने वाले. और उस साल वो मैं इंसिडेंट कभी नहीं भूलूँगा कि मेरे को इंग्लिश लिटरेचर की जो सब्जेक्ट लिया था उसकी किताबें कौन कौन सी थी वो 6 महीने तक ही याद नहीं थी मेरे को.
नो एज निखिल ऑल्सो सेड एक्चुअली आई ऑल्सो वाई आई टुक अप बायोलॉजी विद यू नो फिजिक्स केमिस्ट्री मैथ्स आई रियली डोंट नो यू नो आई वॉज जस्ट काइंड ऑफ इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाई पीपल हु सेड दैट इफ यू चूज biology and after 12th class if you choose to do engineering also later you'll be able to do engineering also if you want to become a doctor you'll be able to become a doctor also. But honestly I didn't have interest in either. neither in engineering nor in
medical.
Anyway, so I also took up biology, and Nikhil was also there. And I remember Nikhil as I said, I was more interested in, very interested in sports. So I wasn't much interested in studies. So I, as far as I remember Nikhil, he was very one of those very quiet people, quiet students, and who would not talk too much. He still doesn't talk too much. And I was also not a very talkative kind. So I didn't have much interaction with him. But this much I saw that, since I was not very interested in studies, I used to look up to people who gave the impression that, they were interested and, they wanted to take up biology and, medical as their future profession.
Talking about Nikhil, of course, the same exactly what Kogan feels about how Nikhil was, a quiet student and focused. So he really, and if I remember correctly, he used to sit on my right. So the aisle was there, and I used to sit on the left side of the aisle. He used to sit on the right side of the aisle. But again, like I said, unfortunately, there was not much interaction because he was a day scholar, I was a boarder. And it was only the association between only the 11th and 12th. Before that, I think we were never in the same class.
True.
Talking about Kogan, always, of course, in the same class and the smartest guy, one of the smartest guy around in class. We always used to feel that, if somebody has to be smart, he has to be as smart as Kogan. And of course, his hockey laurels, which he brought to us, and center half was considered to be the most important position in any sport. The feeder, right, you are the feeder. So great guy.
Thank you.
So hi guys, we are back again. The next episode after dinner, of course, is with our lovely friends here. On my right is Raghuraj Singh. इनके बारे में जो है हम कुछ क्या कहें ये खुद ही अपने बारे में बताएंगे क्योंकि इनकी जो शख्सियत है ये जो शख्सियत है ये ऐसी शख्सियत आपको बहुत कम मिलेगी सिर्फ दिल्ली कॉलेज में नहीं अदरवाइज आल्सो अ पर्सनालिटी लाइक हिम इज सेल्डम सीन राइट सो वी विल कैच हिम विद हिम हियर इज सतवीर सिंह छाबरा करेक्ट सतवीर सिंह छाबरा साहब के साथ जो है हमारा स्कूल का पुराना एसोसिएशन हालांकि हम लोग एक क्लास में कभी लगता है हम पढ़े नहीं बट कॉमर्स ये कॉमर्स में थे हम साइंस में रह गए तो ये मौज मस्ती में अपना निकल गए आगे हम साले पीछे रह गए तो क्या करें तो जो है जो है एंड देयर ऑफ कोर्स आर डॉक्टर साहब रघुनाथ बी दी लाइक अगेन आई वुड लाइक टू रिसाइट माय फादर्स व्हाट ही यूज्ड टू से इज के कुछ लोग जो होते हैं दे आर नॉट द ब्रेन्स आर नॉट हियर द होल बॉडी इज ब्रेन्स सो ही इज़ वन ऑफ दोज के वो पूरी पूरी जो बॉडी है ऊपर से नीचे तक इज ब्रेन्स राइट तो रघु के बारे में एक चीज़ मुझे याद है एक तो इनकी जो बास्केटबॉल की जो शॉट्स होती थी ओहो हो द सेक्सी शॉट्स विद दैट कट ओवर हियर देवर फॉर शॉर्ट्स एंड हिज सेक्सी लेग्स देवर टू डाई फॉर सो आई डोंट नो व्हाट द गर्ल्स वुड से बट वी ऑल यूज टू फील के यार बॉस लेग्स हों तो बॉस रघु जैसी हों राइट सो आई हैव ऑलवेज रिमेंबर्ड हिम लाइक दैट एंड दोज लवली बास्केटबॉल डेज विद हिम इनका एक तरीका होता था ही ऑफ कोर्स विद हिज सॉलिड पर्सनालिटी एंड हिज ह्यूज हाइट एडवांटेज ये जो है पता नहीं आपको याद होगा कि नहीं आप हमेशा हमको एल्बो आउट कर देते थे सो बास्केटबॉल में देयर इज अ वेरी गुड टेक्निक विच यू यूज योर बॉडी स्ट्रेंथ एंड योर फिजिक टू एल्बो आउट द अदर गाय सो दैट ही इज़ नॉट एबल टू कम इन योर वे टू सो ही हैड दैट ब्यूटिफुल टेक्निक So I remember him on that, yeah? So over to you, Raghu. Do you remember anything of that?
I think you bouncing. That's a normal way of playing basketball where you don't let the person get the ball.
Correct.
That's it.
Correct.
And in case you can't protect the ball, then you always lose balls.
Correct. So it's all about having the balls intact.
You normally knock off other person's balls.
Correct.
Your balls are always intact.
Correct.
And so is your basketball.
Correct.
And that's how the game is played. And I think that's how life goes.
Right.
In life also, you protect yourself. You protect your profession. You're protecting my hand.
Yeah, I'm holding your hand. coming to Raghunath B. So there is some connection here. Raghuraj, Raghunath. So you know something getting connected here. So Raghunath, we were of course in our bio batch, right? So you joined DC when?
11th.
Yeah, so he was with us in 11th and 12th. So those golden period of education where you start making your career. So most of us did not, but he was one of the few ones who actually landed up making a career. So great, Raghu, and try and just remember a few things about what we used to do in class. You were probably the serious ones, but if you can tell us something about the non-serious guys, huh?
I think it would be amiss if I missed Mr. Dungarpuria, who was our maths teacher. So my first lovely moment in school was when we had a maths exam, and I had that time was the changeover between traditional maths and the modern maths. Mm. So Dali had modern maths and I had studied traditional maths in my old school. So Dungarpuria, actually when I answered my paper, I solved the problems, but it was done in a very different way from which the students in Dali College were doing. Mm-hmm. So he was very amazed, and he said that, Bhaiya, you did good. Mm-hmm. I don't know what method you did it by, mm-hmm. but he got some good answers and all that. So that's the first moment that I met. Then, of course, I had a lot of lovely friends. I played basketball again with Anagrat Singh. So I used to play basketball in Loyola, so I could play with him. And then we had lovely students there. I remember Sanjeev Sharma, then Anup, Tommy, Nasser, a lot of them, and with whom I could match my wits and, you know, try to do well. So it was a wonderful time. I had wonderful time, 11th and 12th, both years.
So yeah, so what I remember about Raghu was his 28-inch waist, which probably now is 29.
No, 30 now.
Okay, so yeah, 30. So not much difference, right?
A lot of difference. 28 and 30 is a lot.
A lot of difference, but yeah, but then we are like how his legs were to die for, his waist is still to die for, right? So we all wish, including owais behind the camera, I'm sure even you would love to have that waist, right?
Yeah.
So
look, when I came here, I was very happy to see owais. And this sort of kernel. So I felt very comfortable with my own
in the same league. Yeah. In the same league.
No, I'm league plus. They're far more.
Correct. They're far more. Yeah, absolutely. So
thank you to me.
So ye Satveer sahab ke saath ab jo hai, he was one of the commerce stalwarts, and I remember him connecting with him in the annual fete and all. Ek shayad hamare ek photo bhi hai shayad. I think I have a group photograph where we both are there in that photograph. So yes, I remember a few moments and those few times when we have spent some times together. So Satveer, aap jara batao kuch, just try and remember a few things about our good old days.
Old days are just like gold.
Absolutely.
Your whole life is dependent on your school life. What we are today is just because of our school life. I know one of our English teacher, Mrs. Primar, if you remember. Mm-hmm. Once she was teaching English reading classes. There was a chapter reading, like paragraph reading. Mm. Once she told me, you just have one paragraph reading, just turn by turn. Mm. So one phrase came, to leave no stone unturned. Oh. So she asked me, do you know the meaning of to leave no stone unturned? Mm. I was just reading very fast. No, I said, I don't know. Then she explained, to leave no stone unturned means you have to do so hard work. Mm. Just like when, जैसे आप you are कोई खजाना खोजता है और सब जितने भी stones हैं उसको सबको हटा दो.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल.
और तो खजाना मिलेगा.
करेक्ट.
तो आय उसकी उनकी वो बात मेरे लाइफ को चेंज कर दिया.
करेक्ट.
तो मैं वो उनके आज तक वो बात भूलता नहीं हूँ. और दैट थिंग वो मेरी लाइफ में एक बहुत बड़ा एक रोल प्ले किया है व्हाट आई एम टुडे. आई डू एवरीथिंग हार्ड वर्कशिप कि सब कुछ मैं बदल दूं मेहनत करके.
गुड मॉर्निंग, वी मीट वंस अगेन विद ऑल आर बडीज हियर. तो भैया ऐसा है, अभी जरा इंदौरी पे आ जाए हम लोग थोड़े. अभी बहुत अंग्रेजी कुछ ज्यादा ही हो गई लगता है थोड़ा.
सही
कह रही है कि नहीं?
सही कह रही हो.
तो इंदौरी जो उसमें अब हम जोगेश जी इधर हैं हमारे साथ, नरपत जी इधर हैं, तो चीयर्स कर लें पहले.
चीयर्स
का बॉटल. चीयर्स.
एक्सीलेंट ट्रिप टू अलीलाल.
Combined NCC,
the NCC, in which we guys left and went by train till Pathankot.
Correct.
Right? And in the morning of Pathankot, when we reached the station and waiting for those trucks to come in to pick us up to take to Arilal.
Shaktiman.
Yeah. And there was this guy who came shouting around, you know, Chanda, 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 Chanda. And Anoop immediately popped his head out and said, yaar, ye kya hai chanda? Bole, do chanda dena. Bole, chheel ke ya kaise do? Bole, chheel ke dega. So that was two boiled eggs with salt and pepper on it and a kasora of chai. Yeah. So that was a chanda we never forgot. And then of
chai
course,
anda.
Chai and anda.
Oh, so for the lesser this thing.
Chanda.
Chai anda.
China
and
India,
India. So, Chembo had a voracious appetite, you know, and fortunately or unfortunately, the food which we were getting was very nice langar food, but if you eat more than you can digest, you need to go to the, you know, the benches, the cut hold benches.
Correct.
And I think almost in the... -10 is when the, you know, the stuff was all, the trenches were quite filled up and it was slightly drizzling when Chembo went slipping down over there. And I think Keshav Rao and somebody else from that Bihar school virtually pulled out Chembo when he was like,
and
you know.
Keshav was happy to And Keshav was happy to pull him out and spell him.
And then he was cleaned up.
And not to forget the NCC camp director. So
Bath.
He was it Mr. Bath or was it who used to address us?
Mr. Bath.
Mr. Bath. Okay. So he had this typical way of speaking, the typical Fauji style of speaking. And guys used to go and do the big job and the small job in all kind of you know, unwanted places. So we had these urinals where you could do only the small part, not the big job. And the guys used to conveniently go and do the big job in the urinals, you know. So he used to say ke ye maine jahan tahan tatiyan dekhi hain jahan aur jahan tahan pacha pishab daniyon mein bhi tatiyan yahan tatiyan wahan tatiyan
tatiyan hi tatiyan.
I have no idea, but I feel that this name got coined by Ved Sonkar. I think he was the one who in some context or something sometime kept using the yaar tu to boss hai, tu to boss hai, and just caught on after that. Mm-hmm. Now what really the reason was, I to be very honest really don't remember. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So nobody knows at all, yaar, that's a fact.
So anything you can tell about me?
What do you want me to tell about you?
Whatever, you can say anything.
Your seatbelt issue, your story.
That story, I think everybody.
Everybody
knows.
Already knows.
Something
okay.
which people really don't know about. Wo andar ki baat.
Andar ki baat.
Huh?
You know, once had some very wonderful holidays, from class 9 right up to class 10 and 11, when Anoop's dad. We have a common heritage is that our parents were in the army, and one thing which very few people know. Of course, people know that his father was a very eminent dentist. He was the one who also fixed my teeth. So I used to go every month, once on a Sunday to Mau, where his dad used to keep the, you know, go to the dental center to attend, because being an army kid, we had that privilege. And that's really when, and then his dad got posted to a place called Tanga Valley, where my dad was also commanding a brigade. And we started doing our vacations together. And I can say that out of huge amount of emotions, that if I had a brother, it's only this guy.
Hey, what about us here?
And I think the moments we spent in Tanga Valley was from 7 o'clock in the morning to right up to 10 o'clock at night.
Inseparable.
Inseparable, absolutely. Yeah. To an extent that we only had one disagreement, one argument, and we got one. This thing was, oh, kehte na, do kanto ke beech mein ek gulab khil gaya tha. Gulabo.
Kaun thi bhai? Mujhe to pata nahi hai.
So we leave the gulabo out of this because she's not part of the gang. But you know, but we found a solution to that. We had time slots fixed, yeah. Pre-lunch and post-lunch. So I think Anoop, you're the way. Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to bring my emotions out on our brotherhood, which was little beyond this thing. I never felt that I didn't have a brother. I've been an only child, So that gave me a lot, and he's also an only child. So we've had really, you know, an amazing Tanga Valley bond, which till date continues, and God willing will continue always.
Great. Thanks, Yogi. Narpad, ek cheez, the last thing from you.
Yes, yes.
So who are your, Of course, we were all buddies and we were all friends in the, so this thing. But who are your closest buddies whom you can say that you spent most time
most
with?
Most of the time most in of the school. Time.
Yeah, in the school.
In the school. Of course, Mr. Satvir Singh Chhabra. We were always in the balcony of 12th, what was the section? I don't remember. We were always sitting in the balcony. Most of the time we spent in the balcony listening to his discourses.
And looking where?
And looking at the
girls.
So that there comes it. So great.
रानी कब आएगी तू आई रुत मस्तानी कब आएगी तू वीरी गाए जिंदगानी कब आएगी तू चलिया तू चलिया मेरे सपनों की रानी कब आएगी तू आई रुत मस्तानी कब आएगी तू वीरी गाए जिंदगानी कब आएगी तू चलिया तू चलिया भूल सिखिल के पास था दिल के दूर से मिल के चैन आए भूल सिखिल के पास था दिल के दूर से मिल के चैन आए और कब तक मुझे तड़पाएगी तू मेरे सपनों की रानी कब आएगी तू आई रुत मस्तानी कब आएगी कब आएगी तू चलिया तू चलिया की गलियां बागों की गलियां सब रंग रलियां पूछ रही है प्यार की गलियां बागों की गलियां सब रंग रलियां पूछ रही है गीत पनघट पे किस दिन गाएगी तू तेरे सपनों की रानी कब आएगी तू आई रुत मस्तानी कब आएगी तू बीती राय जिंदगानी कब आएगी तू चलिया तू चलिया है भरोसा आशिक दिल का और किसी पे ये आ जाए क्या है भरोसा आशिक दिल का और किसी पे ये
मेरे सपनों की रानी कब आएगी तू आई रुतु मस्तानी कब आएगी तू बीगी आए जिंदगानी कब आएगी तू चलिया मेरे सपनों की रानी कब आएगी तू आई रुतु मस्तानी कब आएगी तू बीगी आए जिंदगानी कब आएगी तू चलिया बदन पे सितारे लपेटे हुए हो जान तमन्ना के दर जा रही हो जरा पास आओ तू चैन जाए जरा पास आओ तू चैन जाए बदन पे सितारे लपेटे हुए हो जान तमन्ना के दर जा रही हो जरा पास आओ तू चैन जाए जरा पास आओ तू चैन जाए
One, go. Hi again, once again, and taking this forward, we have lovely Rajesh Agarwal on my left, and the one and only Amit Karia on my right. And so, going ahead with our vartalap on the good old days, Amit can maybe I'll first talk a little bit about Amit because I had a little brief, a very sweet association because I think he left pretty early from school. So, Amit and we were together in Vikram House in the same room. एंड बम्बई वालों की जो थी बात एक हवा जो थी ठीक है ना वो अलग ही थी अब बम्बई वाला वॉज ऑलवेज टू नॉचेज अबव द रेस्ट ओके सो वी वर ऑलवेज वी वर ऑल सेकेंडरी गाँव वाला तो ये जो थे जनाब इनका चलने का स्टाइल भी ऐसा है और इनके हाँ हीरो वाला स्टाइल और एक हाथ इनका जो अभी अभी भी ऐसा है तो एल्बो इनकी ऐसी है आई स्टिल रिमेंबर द दैट एल्बो विच ही हैड एंड द आर्म्स विच यू सी नाउ आल्सो वर द सेम इन दोज डेज तो अगर ये लफड़ा किसी को पड़ जाए तो उस टाइम पे वह हाथ हालत उसकी ख़राब सो वी हैड टू बी लिटिल केयरफुल विद हिम कि कहीं कहीं इसका हाथ वाथ पड़ गया तो मुश्किल होगी
So
one is बॉम्बे वाला ऊपर पर्सनैलिटी ऊपर हाथ ऐसा तो भैया दूर ही रहे तो अच्छा है बट द बेस्ट पार्ट अबाउट हिम वॉज वी आई यूज टू लव यूजिंग इज ब्रूट द वन एंड ओनली ब्रूट विच विच वी कुड इवन इमेजिन बिकॉज आई वॉज वन ऑफ दो टाटा का यूडी कोलोन ओके जोगी जोगी रिमेंबर्स टाटा का यूडी कुलॉन कैंटीन से आता था हम तो वही ले सकते थे द ओनली पर्सन हु हैड ब्रूट वॉज हिम एंड वी यूज टू फ्लिक फ्रॉम हिज यू नो कभी इधर वो देख लिया तो चल भाई लगा लिया ब्रूट है सो आई डोंट नो वेदर ही रिमेंबर्स दैट सो कैन यू से समथिंग ऑन दैट
नथिंग आई ऑब्वियसली इवन नाउ आई एम वेरी फॉन्ड ऑफ परफ्यूम्स एंड कुलॉन्स एंड एवरीथिंग सो आई नॉट ओनली ब्रूट आई थिंक देयर यूज्ड टू बी एन ओल्ड स्पाइस एज वेल एंड because we had to be rationed about it, so I didn't know that it was getting used somewhere, and in that atmosphere the fragrance obviously would travel, so you would know exactly who's done it. But he was a good friend, so what the hell, it's okay, you know, and that's how it went. But yeah, it was great times. We were in the same room, and like you said, there was that movie Kali Charan, I believe, in which there was the exact same thing, number 17, which when turned around meant lion. And that was, so which our was room be, number was 17.
Which was to be pronounced as lion.
Yeah. So that was lion. That was our room number in those days. And yeah, it was great times. I think we had a fantastic time. I remember something about Anoop. Like he says, I was the aggressive guy, but I remember one incident. There was something he Mehrnosh, as usual, did something, aggravated him. We were in the lineup. And as soon as the lineup got over, this guy crossed across to him and hit him, and the guy fell down. So that's what I remember about Anu. Yeah. Go ahead.
So great. Yeah. So coming to Rajesh, I think you were always a day scholar.
No.
He was in Vikram.
I was in Vikram. Only last year, there is 12 when I met an accident.
I remember.
No, so you were always in Vikram.
Yes.
Yeah.
But initially, I think you were a day scholar.
Right through, I was a boarder.
He was a boarder.
He was the one, yeah, with all the tail, yeah.
Hey, wo to theek hai, but I used to. So, which year were you a day scholar then?
Only last year, 12th.
Okay.
Because I met with an accident.
Oh no! This is one of those memories memory losses. Yeah. So, क्या कहना चाहेंगे उस टाइम के बारे में?
Yeah.
ऐसे ही थोड़ी बोलते थे यार.
That is very right. Amit is saying.
Absolutely.
I used to do a small prayer every morning, so everyone started calling me Pandit, and that was very sweet. We used to like them. Pawan used to call me Hari Om, and we still address each other as Hari Om.
So I remember you were in the niche wala room, na? Dikshit, apna house master ke room wala.
Yeah, and then on the top left dormitory.
Yeah, yeah.
Sharing with Tommy and all.
Yeah.
Those were good days, and then eventually in 12th class I met with an accident, and everyone of you.
You had a broken.
Which went for a year long.
Correct.
And everyone was very good and cooperative. And I had a very bad year, but fortunately passed the same year.
So, yaar, can you tell something about our house masters?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so Mr. Sure. Dikshit, I think you must have been close to him. Yeah?
Yes. Mr. Dikshit has always been a very strong hand, at least in those days, and even. Eventually, even after leaving Delhi College, he maintained the image when he went to Mansoor and other places. But he, I must tell you, he remembers the name of each and every student from the house, especially. And he, whenever he meets, he asks about all the batchmates, and he remembers them by name. And he was very strong, but he was good at heart. He was good at heart because there were various occasions when we had difficulties, and he was very, very cooperative. And he was one of the pillars of Delhi College in those days. Principals kept on changing, but he was one of the strong guys, yeah. Along with Salim Khan sir.
Okay, so now very something which I always was amazed when I never knew at that time that he and Sangeeta. I was not aware.
Yeah.
So it was a big surprise when I got reconnected and I came to know that he's married to Sangeeta. So how could he keep it under wraps, and none of us knew anything about it? Huh? So just throw some light on that.
That's a good question.
So yeah. Just to keep the record straight, there were four permanent girls, and as such 14 girls in the entire school of strength. That time used to be 600, the entire school strength, and only 14 girls, four girls in our class. I came in the seventh in the second term, and obviously I saw Sangu and she was amazing, but I knew what the competition was. But and I was very young, but yeah, she caught my fancy, and there was no way I was going to be able to patao her that easily. But
so this was in 10th itself? Or
yeah, it started in 7th itself, but obviously it went on till 8th, 9th. Then in 9th, somehow, like I said, I had befriended Suresh, who was pally to Sangu, and I had conveyed to him that I like Sangu, and he probably conveyed it to her. And so I think Sangu started paying a little more attention to me. I didn't have the guts to tell her anything. And then there was an incident about somebody writing a letter to her, some nasty letter, and then she confronted me, at which point I got aggressive and I said, it hasn't been me, and what do you think of yourself? It was obviously, it came out wrong, but I think that's when the two of us at least started to talk. Then I left Delhi College. I went back to Bombay, starting my college. She started calling me up. Long distance. Initially, my mom picked up. She wouldn't tell who. Then my mom insisted, because those days phones were not that easy. It was one phone. Kids never got to use the phone, but she kept calling. And then my mom says, somebody's calling, Sangeeta from Indore. So I said, strange. I was obviously elated, but that's how the relationship started. Obviously, then we met in Bombay. Then I came back to Indore in Rajan House for 1 month, just because she was there and we had started our affair. And that's how it went. Yeah.
So great to know on the records and the art from the archives. Huh?
Yeah.
So,
from the horse's mouth.
Thank you.
सीधा साधा एक
This was the only prank I think I did my in my DC days.
Okay, so I was a good boy then.
Yeah, I was a good boy.
Chalte, chalte, mere ye geet yaad rakhna, kabhi alvida na kehna.